Hey everyone, it's Greg, and today's going to be another quick video on how to optimize your SEO for a Wix website. So like I said, it's going to be quick, so let's jump right into it. So the first one's actually a trick, and on a side note, don't mind this template here, it's just something I've been using as reference for YouTube videos. So the first thing is to turn off your scrolling effects. So scrolling effects make it very hard for Google to read information from your site. And because it's HTML5 in Wix, you can easily throw off a lot of things they don't want to. So to turn this off, all we gotta do is change background strip, come to settings, and let's just move this out of the way. And then you should have, how does the website scroll, which is right here. So see, it's on parallax, and that's set on a lot of templates by default because it looks really good when someone's on your website. Well, let's just turn that off. And look, to show you the difference here, if we put it on parallax and then we do preview, watch what this does when you scroll. As you can see, the text kind of moves more than as you like this whole effect right here. So that's what parallax is, but it throws off a lot of things on the back end. So when we come back in here and we just turn that off, it still looks just as good. None right here, and we'll preview that. Now it just scrolls just like that. But it makes it a lot easier for Google to get information from your website, therefore you can rank higher. So that's the first one. And then the second one is also here with text. So to make sure that what you want to rank for and what your keywords are, so if you are a photography business in North Dakota, then you wanna write on your website that you do photography in North Dakota. And then what you wanna do with that text is double click it and heading tag, make sure that you're on heading one. Now, H1, H2, and H3 are all things that'll be referenced by Google as important, and in that order too. So one is the most important, two, and then three. So things that you really want to stand out keywords wise, put in H1. And what's cool is you can highlight text within a text box and make some of it H1 and some of it H2 or some of it P for paragraph where it doesn't really reference anything. So just go through your site and make sure that you have things that are that you want to be ranked for as H1. And then there's two more things that we want to do here, and that is over in the dashboard. So what we're going to do is come up to settings, and then we'll go to my dashboard. Just move this out of the way. And then we'll come down to settings again. And we'll go to SEO. Now at the bottom, make sure that this is turned on. You want this to be blue. Allow search engines to include your site in search results. If this is turned off, then all of this is for naught because you won't even be referenced in Google or anywhere. So make sure that's turned on. And the second thing is go through the Wix SEO Wiz is what it's called. I knew it was called Wix SEO Wiz. And all you gotta do here is hit let's go and it'll ask you like 15 different questions, allow you to plug in keywords, and it basically optimizes your whole site. So make sure you go through the Wix SEO Wiz there. And there's one last thing that I do want to touch on here before I finish up this video is to make sure that you have SEO on each of your different pages. So how we do that is just come up to the top and you'll see all your pages here and do manage pages. Now on each of these pages, you can actually adjust the SEO, how you're showing up in Google in that search results. So how you do that is click the three dots, SEO and social, and now you have all of this to customize. So you can plug in your keywords here and you can make it look really good. So make sure that you're putting in things that you want to rank for. So put in your keywords through here and make it look like a human wrote it. If you write it really robotic and you're just trying to stuff in keywords, Google sees right through that and they see that as keyword stuffing and they won't rank you higher. So write it in plain English. Write it like you're talking to someone, but make sure you put your keywords in there. And then you have keywords right here. You can write out a list of keywords. It'll cut you off at a certain amount of characters. So fit in as many as you can, separate them by commas, and then copy that and paste the keywords onto every single page here. So as you go into the other ones, we'll do the same thing. That's actually an anchor, so we can't do it on that, but we'll do it on all the other pages as well. So hopefully that helps you guys. I'm gonna bring myself back up here. If you have any questions about that, feel free to reach out to me and I'll get back to you. Leave them in the comments. If you have any specific videos about Wix that you want me to make, just let me know and I'll make a whole video for you. Otherwise, the last two things are, I've got my Wix referral code down in the description. So if you are gonna make a website, I really appreciate it if you use my Wix referral code. The whole sign up and everything is exactly the same for you, but if you decide to go to a premium plan down the road on a Wix website, I get a small commission for referring you. So if you don't wanna use that, I completely understand. You can just go to wix.com and check it all out. But if you do use it, I really appreciate it. The second thing is, if you need help putting together your whole Wix website, I've got a full tutorial in another YouTube video. I'll link to that in the description as well. It's like a 50-minute tutorial from literally signing up, choosing your template, customizing the whole thing, all the way to publishing your new website. So if you have any questions, let me know. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, helps my channel a ton. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.